my studies, not Quidditch or sports. And then a boy James Potter always picked on me, playing games and calling names like Snivellus Snape. Years later became a teacher, master of the dark arts, and I learned of James's death, killed by Lord Voldemort. Also killed Potter's wife, her name was Lily. Only one to survive was their child named Harry. They said he's the chosen one, eventually in my class, chosen by Gryffindor. He was a pain in my ass. He was famous for surviving the spell for killing, but clearly fame isn't everything. Professor Severus Snape with his long black cape, head of Slytherin, House of the Snake, and Half-Blood Prince, professor of defense potions, master at Hogwarts. He's not a pleasant man, and he seems like he's bad, picking on Harry Potter in front of the class. And though they debate, he would do what it takes to protect this place. He's Severus. Didn't like him like me. There was Lucius and his son Draco Malfoy. However, I'll admit, things started to get weird ever since Harry Potter started attending class here. Professor Quirrell let in a troll at Halloween, never trusted him again. Then at the Quidditch game, Harry's broom was bewitched. It was Quirrell I could see, and I muttered a counterspell, but his friends thought it was me. They set fire to my cloak, but his concentration broke, and Harry ended up catching the snitch and winning the game. Later on we found he was helping the Dark Lord, living off of Quirrell's body and the blood of unicorns, trying to get the Sorcerer's Stone and get back a body of his own. Quirrell's death only slowed down Voldemort. Me and Lockhart had to teach the students defense against the dark arts. Once the Chamber of Secrets was open, finding petrified children caused by a basilisk, Harry found the diary of Tom Riddle, who was Voldemort back when he was little. Helped him find the chamber right in the middle of the school. Entered like a fool, but he slayed the basilisk, and I guess that's kinda cool. A while later, Sirius Black, a prisoner of Azkaban, escaped across the land. He's a bad man. Dementors from the prison circling the school, looking for this fool. This isn't cool, we must be careful. A few changes were made to the staff. Hagrid is a teacher now, and Dumbledore got a new hat. Also, Professor Lupin using boggarts in his studies, which is quite ridiculous if you think about that. Lupin's missing classes, wondering where his ass is, just so happens to be when Sirius Black is soon to attack. And even though I prefer to walk out the door, turn to page 394. Professor Severus Snape with his long black cape, head of Slytherin, House of the Snake, and Half-Blood Prince, professor of defense potions, master at Hogwarts. He's not a pleasant man, and he seems like he's bad, picking on Harry Potter in front of the class. And though they debate, he would do what it takes to protect this place. He's Severus Snape. Harry found a magic map that showed Peter Pettigrew. Pettigrew died years ago, or so we know. Followed Lupin into a tree, and it appeared to me that he had been helping Sirius Black lately. Through some discussion, we realized Black was framed. It was Ron's Ratscuffers who followed he who shall not be named. Pettigrew was an animagus in hiding for 12 years, but then Lupin saw the moon into a werewolf he changed. Pettigrew got away, and after many days, the Triwizard Tournament started, and students placed their names into the Goblet of Fire, and then started the race. Underwater, facing dragons, then into a giant maze. I noticed someone was stealing from my potion store to make polyjuice potion in order to transform. Didn't know who it was, and I have no more. But back to the tournament, Harry is leading the score. He heads into the maze with Cedric Diggory, and then he sees the cup, it's a portkey. Takes him to a place with Pettigrew, he killed Diggory. Traps Harry, had a ceremony, and he brought back the Dark Lord. Harry got away barely with the portkey, brought him back to the game, and we all see Harry is taken aside by Mad-Eye Moody. He tried to kill him, and when we realized, he started changing. Barty Crouch Jr. was the one stealing from me, and he assumed the identity of Moody. After time went by, we began training to prevent Voldemort from controlling Harry. While he's protected by the Order of the Phoenix, Dumbledore has a plan for me to be a double agent. Wants me to kill him to gain Voldemort's trust. Protect Harry from within, so I'll do what I must. And take tangled with the Death Eaters, Bellatrix Lestrange, and Lucius Malfoy planning on having Draco do the same. When the time came in the tower, everybody saw the unforgivable curse of Avada Kedavra.